places that should be wonders of the world. Hey everyone, it's Alexa, and welcome back to another video. The pyramids, the Colossus of Rhodes, the Hanging Gardens of Babylon. Those are a few of the wonders of the world. The Earth is big and wide, so why limit yourself to just seven? Here are places that we think deserve to be marveled at. But before we get into today's video, make sure that you're subscribed and ring the bell so that you never miss any of our upcoming videos. On the table. Its full title is Valley of the Gates of the Kings, and hopefully that gives you an idea of just how magnificent this place is. The Valley of Kings is located in Egypt's Theban Hills, west of the Nile River. Egyptians built the structures from the limestone and sedimentary rock over 500 years, from the 16th to the 11th century BC. Much of the foundation was excavated to make room for resting places meant for pharaohs and other prominent members of the nobility. As late as 2008, there have been discoveries to the complex, including new entrances and rooms. Michoacán's Cornfield Volcano. Located in the Mexican state of Michoacán is a volcano that suddenly appeared in 1943 after an eruption. Before, this place was the site of farmer Dionisio Pulido's cornfield. The volcano's quick emergence has intrigued scientists and the general public alike. For modern science, this was the first instance experts were able to document the full cycle of an eruption of this type. The explosion left a 1,391-foot-high cinder cone, damaging an area of 90 square miles. The crater measures 660 feet across. While scientists say the volcano is extinct, it is still scorching, and any rainwater that comes in turns to steam. Crystal Caves of Bermuda. We always hear about the Bermuda Triangle, but there's more to Bermuda than a mystical spot where transportation vessels disappear. Aside from the beautiful tropical scenery and great weather, there are also the Crystal Caves. They are located in Hamilton Parish and measure 1,640 feet long and 203 feet deep. That sounds pretty intense, but many people take tours of the caves during their Bermuda vacations. Crystal formations line the ceiling of the tunnels, making it feel like you're walking into a fantasy movie. One of the prominent features, Harrington Sound, has a plethora of hidden waterways. Foxy Ice. We traveled to New Zealand's South Island. Located on the west coast is Fox Glacier, an 8-mile-long maritime glacier that descends 8,500 feet into a rainforest. It was named in 1872 after the then Prime Minister, Sir William Fox. As of 1998, it is also officially known as Te Moeka o Tuawe. Lots of people trek this ice since it's one of the most accessible glaciers in the world, with over 1,000 visitors hiking every day during tourist season. Unfortunately, Fox Glacier is retreating, and scientists say it's on its way to disappearing entirely. Alhambra, former Roman ruins. We know there's an Alhambra in California, but for this next one, we're going to the original. The Alhambra is located in Granada, Andalusia, Spain. This palace and fortress date back to its humble beginnings as a small Roman fortification in 889 AD. In the mid-13th century, the then Emirate of Granada renovated the ruins into the structure you see now. Moorish poets called Alhambra a pearl set of emeralds, referring to the wall's beautiful coloring, which contrasts the green forests surrounding it. The Great Yellowstone. What? You mean Yellowstone isn't a world wonder yet? That may surprise some of you. Yellowstone National Park is home to a variety of amazing sights, all 100% natural. Hundreds of species of mammals, reptiles, fish, and birds have been documented here, while the forests and grasslands grow species of plants that are unique to the region. Then there are the formations, such as the Grand Canyon Waterfalls, the Yellowstone River, the Grand Prismatic Spring, and much, much more. Native Americans have lived in Yellowstone for at least 11,000 years. This place is beautiful, and all 3,468 square miles deserves to be a wonder of the world. Diamond in the Desert. Siwa Oasis was once an ancient settlement. You'll find it in the middle of the vast Sahara Desert. It was isolated for so many years that the peoples there developed their own unique language called Siwi. Surrounding this city are endless dunes without much life in sight. If you visit Siwa, you'll find a bustling town that offers lively festivals, but also many places to just sit and relax. Siwa Oasis remains as one of Egypt's most isolated settlements, with only 33,000 people living here. The Stone Warriors. It all started in 1974 when a group of villagers decided to dig around for a well and instead came across one of the most incredible ancient finds of the 20th century, the terracotta soldiers. You've probably seen these statues before, the ones depicting the soldiers under the direction of the first emperor of China, Qin Shi Huangdi. The life-size figures appear to have unique faces, suggesting that they were all modeled after real people. They've been sitting underground for 2,000 years along with their terracotta horses, a genuinely marvelous and massive piece of artwork to behold. The Lost City. The name Ciudad Perdida literally translates from Spanish to Lost City. This archaeological site is located in the mountainous forests of Colombia and used to be the ancient city of Sierra Nevada, Santa Marta. Experts think the ancient peoples founded the settlement around 800 CE. A group of local treasure looters discovered Ciudad Perdida in 1972 after stumbling across the stone steps. They followed the stairs and there they found old ceramic urns and golden figurines, items that ended up on the black market, which brought in the attention of archaeologists. The Church of St. George. Most of us see churches all the time, but we bet they weren't carved from a volcanic rock. Up next is the Church of St. George, located in Lalibela, Ethiopia. There are 10 other rock-hewn monolithic churches in this city, but St. George is among the most famous. From the top, you can see the designers made it so that it looks like an intricate Greek cross. The builders shaped the structure from the inside out. They also connected it to the other churches via a series of tunnels. Floating in the Dead Sea. Between Jordan and Israel is the world-famous Sea of Salt, better known as the Dead Sea. Its location counts the Earth's lowest elevation on land at 1,412 feet below sea level. The Dead Sea is the saltiest body of water on Earth with a salinity of 34.2%. All that salt helps people float easily and also lends it some medicinal benefits. People with conditions such as psoriasis, osteoarthritis, and rhinosinusitis come here as part of their treatment. Visit the Dead Sea before it disappears. Its current surface area is 234 square miles, which sounds enormous, but it used to be 410. The Fundy Waves. Water seems peaceful and still when you're staring at a cup of it or even a backyard pool. Water in nature, however, is a different story. Ocean waves carved out the land we see today. The Bay of Fundy is one of those creations by the sea. Visit this coastal area between Canada's New Brunswick and Nova Scotia to see the Bay of Fundy. It is dotted with strange-looking rocks that were twisted and cut by the bay's tidal waves. Good news for fans of Fundy. For the longest time, it was considered one of the seven wonders of North America, but had yet to reach international status. Then, in 2014, a panel of experts decided it would be one of the natural wonders of the world. Hopefully, some of the other places on this list follow suit. Ireland's most majestic cliffs. The Cliffs of Moher's appearance is known around the world. There's a reason it's been featured in so many movies. These cliffs are in the Burren region of Ireland. They rise from the Atlantic Ocean at an average height of 390 feet, though the tallest portion reaches 702. Moher serves as Ireland's most popular tourist destination and one of the most visited places in the world. Around 1.5 million people visit every year. Through the River Bend. If and when you take a trip to the south of France, make sure you stop by the Verdon Gorge, which is very close to the summer destination, the French Riviera. Verdon Gorge measures 15 miles long and 434 feet deep. After the Grand Canyon, it's the second biggest canyon in the world. A smaller waterway within the gorge is the Styx du Vernon, named after the river in Greek mythology. The Pyramids of Mesoamerica. Why should Egypt's pyramids of Giza get all the love? Mexico has monuments built by ancient peoples that are just as impressive. Teotihuacan, an ancient Mesoamerican city, sits in the sub-valley of the Valley of Mexico, some 25 miles northeast of Mexico City. The complex began as a religious center in the first century CE and later became the biggest and most populated settlement in the pre-Columbian Americas. It is the country's most frequented archaeological site. In 2017, over 4.1 million tourists visited. The Marble Caves of Patagonia. Here is another natural formation carved by nature, which goes to show how incredible the elements are. The marble caves in Chile are awe-inspiring, to say the least. Also known as Cuevas de Marmol, you will find this cavern in the Patagonian Andes. They formed after 6,000 years of the lake currents wearing away at the marble rock, creating these smooth surfaces. If you want to take in this marvelous place for yourself, you can take a 30-minute boat tour through the caves. Good Reef. Ah, the Great Barrier Reef, the most extensive coral reef system in the world. It has over 2,900 individual reefs and makes up 900 islands that stretch over an area of 133,000 square miles. If you were to travel in a spaceship over the Earth's atmosphere, you would still be able to see the Great Barrier Reef. It is located off the coast of Queensland, Australia, and is frequented not only by the billions of organisms, big and small, but also by humans. People visit the beach, snorkel, ships pass through, and fishers see it as a prime spot. Before we reveal number one, we've got a question for you. What is the top destination on your bucket list? Let us know in the comments below. 1. The Acropolis of Athens. This ancient city sits on a rocky outcrop that overlooks the city of Athens. Within this compound are several edifices with historical significance. Does a little place called the Parthenon sound familiar? We thought it might. Occupation of the hill goes as far back as the 4th millennium BC. Many modern scholars see the Acropolis as a central symbol of classical Greece. During its heyday, Acropolis was the venue for the Panathenaea, which was a festival similar to the magnitude of the Olympic Games, and also took place every 4 years.